Hello, hello, welcome to a new Legacy video. Today we're playing Tezzerator. Tezzerator is an old name, comes from Tezzeret the Seeker. Now Tezzeret the Seeker is gone, but we have three other Tezzeret. We have Tezzeret the Schemer, that will help us kill some creatures as well as creating an artifact and having a powerful emblem very soon. Tezzeret Agent of Bolas, that will help us get through our deck or just attack with strong artifacts or eventually kill our opponent. And then finally Tezzeret Artifice Master. This is a new Tezzeret for 0 draw 2 cards, basically. That's pretty strong. 4 Force of Will, but before that, let's talk about the core of the deck, the Antiquities of War. 4 mana, look at top 5 cards, and you may reveal an artifact and put it in your hand for 2 times. This, for whoever didn't draft Dominaria, is a Cold Saga, and they triggers in your main phase. So immediately after you draw a step, this goes to the stack, and you can look up top 5 and do that. And then in the third chapter, so this comes into play, you do the first chapter. Second turn, you do the second chapter. Third turn, all your artifacts becomes 5/5 power and toughness, just like the Tezzeret the Seeker ultimate. What else do we have? We have Karn, Cyanide Wards are very strong with a deck like this because we have full of artifacts. Darcy Citadel, Seed of Cyanide, World to Whisper, Mox Opal, Dimir Signet, Baleful Strix, Bridge, Walking Ballista, Chalice, and Explosive. So basically, only artifacts in this deck. The only non-artifacts cards are Thoughtcast and Force of Will, as well as some Planeswalkers and the Antiquities of War. So basically, the core of the deck is to just assemble as many artifacts as you can, stop your opponent with like a Snaring Bridge, Baleful Strix, some Tezzeret the Schemer, Karn, and then eventually just win the game with either Tezzeret Agent of Bolas or Walking Ballista. Of course, Chalice also stopping your opponent from casting their card. In the sideboard, we have Pedim, Council of Innovation. This was a cooling standard. 4 mana, 1/4. Artifacts you control have X-proof. And at the beginning of your upkeep, if you control the highest converted mana cost or tied for an artifact, that you draw a card. And in deck, in this deck, you generally do, because it's not that there's that many artifacts in standard. Flaster Storm, Blue Elemental Blast, a couple of Dread of Night, Ley Lines, of course, Painful Truth, that looks pretty weird, but it does draw you 3 cards with Mox Diamonds and Mox Opal, and then Sorcerer's Spyglass. Maybe you can find better option for this Painful Truth, but this was the list that I found, and I figured that this went 5-0, so I figured that we can just run this back and let's see how it goes. So yeah, very excited to play this deck, seems very fun, so let's head down to it. But before that, let me remind you that Channel Fireball is the website that's sponsoring us, so if you see this deck played, it's just because of them, so don't hesitate to go on channelfireball.com whenever you need some cards. They also have Guilds of Ravnica cards, so yeah, check that out. And what's better than to, in Ancient Tomb, Chalice of the Void, do your opponent mulligan in? Yes, the answer is being on the play, but unfortunately we're not. Playing as MGM80, which I believe we played like yesterday, or... I mean, for you it's not yesterday, but for me it was yesterday. Let's see what he was playing. Alright. Let's go. Ancient Tomb, Chalice of the Void. Can play the brainstorming response, but hopefully don't find anything with it. I could play Karn turn 2, that's huge if he's miracle. If he's miracles. Okay, four speech Delver of Secrets. Wow, they didn't play Delver? Oh, they scratched to the top maybe? They scratched the bottom. Wow, that's bold. I don't even know if bold means anything in this sentence, but I felt like saying it. Alright, Tropical Island Pass. And yeah, I guess I'll play Karn. What's this? Daze? That's unfortunate. I didn't expect Daze because I didn't play last turn. I decided to play 4 Speech Delver and then not play turn 2. So it's not that they didn't Daze because they wanted to keep land in order to play turn to something. So they clearly drew Daze right now, which is very bad for us. Now we have nothing left. We use an Ensnaring Bridge. And if our opponent plays red, we might just die to Bolt. Yeah, I think I'll play Bridge here. And I'll cast Mox Opal. Alright. Alright. Passes. And we draw something good. Nope. Alright, I don't think I want to play Walking Ballista right now. I'd rather just wait and tap just four, not Ancient Tombs. I don't think it makes that much difference. Yeah, and now, yeah, this is also why. Because if I just play Walking Ballista, my opponent just bolts it or fail push it or whatever, I would have just done no value, whereas I want to do value. And I'm gonna just do it now. I just don't want to tap this Ancient Tomb. I don't think it makes that much difference if we cast Thoughtcast now or later. I'll do it now because if I let them see the top card in upkeep with Delver, there's just nothing I can do. Because the Delver just see the top cards and flip. It's not that passes you priority. So you just do it now. Right, so at this point I have a bunch of payoff, I have a lot of planeswalkers, and the Antiquities of War, which will definitely be lethal with all those artifacts. I guess we have Ensnaring Bridge, so it will not. But I might drop to 5 cards, just to set up that plan. Alright, our Delver opponent is taking a very slow route. Nimble Mongoose. Okay. Maybe they didn't Delver turn one because they had Stifle. So if you have Stifle and your opponent leads with a Ancient Tomb Chalice, you definitely pitch Stifle and not Delver. So I'm not sure. Ooh, Tezzeret the Schemer. Okay, let's cast Thoughtcast first. And let's cast the Schemer. Which will have an emblem very soon. Again, the Nimble Mongoose means that I can't kill it, which it's not great. But we have an emblem that can turn on my artifacts forever, and then I don't think there's a way for me to kill this this Ensnaring Bridge. I guess explosives. Rather than bolting the Walking Ballista, but then it has to be very very careful on not putting a seventh card in the graveyard. Because if they do, then the Himamagus can't attack anymore. Also, by them playing Lightning Bolt targeting the Walking Ballista means that I'm not dying to 4 Lightning Bolts anymore. Which is great. Great news. Since I was very afraid of that. Okay, opponent's attacking Tez for the Schemer. And I pass. We draw the Antiquities of War. I'm gonna play it. Could have make a sell first. I don't know why I did not. Cause I'm not gonna do anything else with this Tezzeret. Wow, opponent concedes. Cool. We would have hit just land. But yeah, then eventually, I don't know, won somehow. The bridge was pretty good there. Okay, so what do we want here? We can... I'm gonna cut Force of Wills. Everything else looks okay. I can board in Blue Elemental Blast, maybe Padim. Padim looks cool. Do it dies to Red Elemental Blast, that's pretty bad. I don't think I want Ley Lines. I mean, Ley Line shuts off Tarmogoyf and Nimblebongus, which is quite a lot. And we can easily cast it. I think I like maybe on the... No, I think I like Padim. Let's go with this. Game number two, our opponent disconnected, so I restarted the recordings and nothing much happened. Opponent played Land Go, Brainstorm end of turn, we played an Undestructible Land, and now Nimble Mongoose into the Elder. Okay, that's good. That's good for them. And I think I'll just try with a Chalice right now. I would go slower, but my opponent put up a strong clock, so I just want to hope he doesn't have days. Alright, flipped with Brainstorm. And attacked me for 4. Down to 16. Now the Inventor's Farewell helped me a lot. Gaining 1 life per turn, it's pretty good. Ooh, and Tarmogoyf. Alright, what's next? Mirror Signet. I have 3 artifact, so I'll cast the 4th one. And then I'll play Thoughtcast. I could play the Mirror Signet, but then I can't draw 2 cards. Maybe just to set up it where next turn is better, and I just use my mana right now. I can also just draw Mox Opal and be able to cast everything. By everything, I mean the Mirror Signet. I think I'll cast the Mirror Signet here, over the Thoughtcast. Also, Thoughtcast being a sorcery means that the Tarmogoyf deals me 1 more damage, and that's not something to sleep on. So now they attack me for 6, unless they put like, wow, okay, tribal, cool. So I just discarded the card to give a +1/+1 to Tarmogoyf. Fair enough. So 7 damage, I go to 9. I need to draw a bridge right now. So I go up to 10 now with Inventor's Fair. Now let's see. Baleful Strix. Alright, again, let's start with Thoughtcast. There's a bridge. Can we bait something? So we have at our disposal 1, 2, 3, 4. I think I just want to play around Daze if I can. So I'll play Bridge first. And now, actually, now I think about it, this bridge is even that is not even that good. Because my opponent, because I have 3 cards in hand. I mean, there's nothing I can do, right? Maybe I can just play a Strix first. But next turn, Bridge will definitely stop everything. Bridge plus Padim is the game. So this turn I shouldn't die, right? Because it's 4 + 4, 8. Yeah, I think it's better for me if I just do this order. Bridge and then Strix. And if I put into Daze is the Strix. Oh, now Tarmogoyf can't attack. Okay, they have Force. It's unfortunate. If this Padim was a Force of Will, maybe I should have kept Force of Will in. Alright, let's play Strix. What did they pitch? Brainstorm. Alright, more Thoughtcast. Okay, but this Strix is still very strong. Let's me block Tarmogoyf, which is a 5/6 right now. And I take 4. Oh, Ancient Grudge, and that's the game right there. 10 damage. Coming across. Okay, good game. Good game. Opponent had 2 very strong cards when I thought I was about to turn the corner. Maybe on the play, Force of Will is better, since I can It's less likely that they, but if Ancient Grudge, I really like this Padim, and Force of Will might be really risky. Maybe Blue Elemental Blast is just not good. I'll just have two Force of Will, the same number of blue cards since we just did two for two. Maybe I can cut the Antiquities of War. Just too slow, maybe one. All right, let's go. Round number three, sorry, game number three. Okay, isn't this fine? Nothing special, but we have mana. We have a lot of mana. And it's usually good against a deck with Wasteland. All right, turn one Delver. Okay, cast the Mirror Signet and pass the turn. Next turn I can cast the Mirror Signet and Strix and Thoughtcast. That's a pretty good turn. More Delvers. I wish this Tezzeret was the Schemer instead of Agent of Bolas. Ooh, a Snaring Bridge. It's a powerful one. Alright, so let's cast the Mirror Signet. Let's cast Strix. And let's cast Thoughtcast. Alright, this is a Red Elemental Blast, maybe. I still think it was better to sequence that way, this way. Ooh, couple of Mox Opals. Let's play one and pass the turn. Alright, let's see if this Delver flips. Hopefully not. Oh, it did flip with Brainstorm. Alright. Now we hope to draw a Force of Will, I guess. I might have just Ancient Grudge or a Braid for my bridge. Winter Orb. Okay. We still have our Signets and Opals. Oh, that's a Force of Will. Alright. So I'll cast a Bridge. Maybe I just want to play another Opal, just to play around the Spell Pierce. Maybe I want to do it. Also, if this bridge resolves, I want to play, yeah, I think I'll do it. Because if this bridge resolves, I want to have two cards in hand. Let's see. So now we're playing around Spell Pierce, Daze, or F Force of Will, and we sideboarded Force of Will, and there you have it. Okay, bridge is down. Opponents have one card, hopefully they don't find their Ancient Grudge, or we find our Padim. We have two Padims in the deck. Okay. Brainstorm, I guess the Peach Brainstorm, right, so that's an additional Brainstorm. Grimlomancer, alright, this can deal 12 damage through the bridge. The Winter Orb is not very friendly with Grimlomancer. Alright, something good, please. Alright, Strix. Enchanting. And opponent can start attacking as... No, they don't want to use the Lavamancer. Because they want to untap their lands. Okay, they pass. Good, so they didn't find any Ancient Grudge. Keep on drawing lands, pretty bad. We need to find some payoff right now. And put a start attacking us. With Lavamancer, we go down to 10. We have still a lot of turns. Also because my opponent, it's not very easy to just put 10 cards in the graveyard. I mean, they have to put 7 cards in the graveyard. I mean, it's kinda easy. You just have to play spells. Oh, there it is, Padim. Okay. Let's just hope it resolves. Come on, resolve, please. Please resolve. I mean, they can kill Padim with like Lavamancer plus Bolt, but if they don't, we start drawing 2 cards and our bridge as X-proof. Okay, they deal 2 damage to us, which might be a good sign. Might mean that they don't have a way to deal with Padim. Ooh, they bolt us, that's not a good sign. And we're dead. Yep, we just died to a flurry of bolts. Bolt Lavamancer. Green Lavamancer, definitely good. I think this was a good game. This was a very, very good match. Interesting, definitely. Okay, we'll be back for round number 2 with more actions with Tezzerator. Alright, round number 2. On the blade, we have a Chalice turn 1. We don't... What does this end accomplish? So we can go Mox Diamond, discard Underground Sea, Dark Seal Citadel, Mox Opal. Yeah, that's cool. Alright. Witch keep on 7. Mox Diamond, discard. I'll discard this, I'll keep Ancient Tomb around. I can even go Ballista for 1. I'd rather just do this. Oof, Salt of Lands. I'd rather just Ballista for 2 next turn, then Ballista for 1. Next turn I can cast any 4 or 5s. And... Alright, Eldrazi Temple. Do they have a Chalice? No, they have a Mimic. Okay. They're gonna kill the Mimic. With a Walking Ballista. Maybe if I'd play Walking Ballista turn 1, they wouldn't have made this play and I wouldn't get my 2 for 1. So that's good. Hmm, 4 mana, so they can play Thanatseer. And unfortunately I drew Force of Will, so they would discard that. Any other spell would have probably been better. Because it would have cast all the expensive cards. And all the cheap one too. Or Moderate Shaper though, that's fine by me. And they pass, okay. Let's draw something good, please. Walking Ballista is not. Alright, I'll pass. And I have Force to fill up for their Reality Smasher. Unless they have a Cavern of Souls. Unless they have a Cavern of Souls. Alright, they attack. They might just block. No. No, I just pumped Ballista end of turn. if nothing happens, but I doubt it. Alright, I can wasteland my Ancient Tube, I guess. Or State of Silence 2. The Ancient Tube, sure. Could have floated mana, but that would have mean that I would have lost 2 life. So... yeah. If I float 2 mana and it doesn't, and nothing happens, or like it just plays like a weak card, I just lost 2 damage there. Sure. Not exciting. Not exciting draws from our side. Now we're gonna block the Endless One and kill the Mother Shaper with a Walking Ballista. Then we're forced post combat. Or again, if they play something. Okay. Remove the other one and remove the other one. Alright, Eldrazi Mimic has been revealed, which comes straight into play. We take no damage. I expect another Endless One, or I guess Endbringer now. Oh, Thalnut's here. Okay. Six mana, cast Walking Ballista, ping the Mimic, and pass. Now my opponent, think they have, I mean, they play one land per turn, so they can easily have a couple of lands in their hand. Okay, go down to 13 in the meanwhile. Next turn with the Ancient Tomb, I can put up the Ballista up to 4. What's that? What's that? City of Traders, so they have a lot of mana here. What's that, 8? Endless One? That's huge. I don't really have ways to deal with an 8-8, do I? This Karn makes a 8-8? Oh, there it is. So we make an 8-8. The Walking Ballista is very important to stay alive for my construct to be an 8-8. I mean, I still have Walking Ballista, so even if Wasteland. Now Wasteland can destroy the Seat of Cyanide and the construct will be a 7-7. But I still have Walking Ballista to ping the Endless One. Okay, so what can I do is block the Endless One. Yes, both attacks. So I'll do like this. Go to blocks. I'll do like this. Then I'll say okay. And then I'll ping this Endless One. And then I'll let damage resolve. Sure. Alright. We untap, draw Thoughtcast. Pretty solid draw. Ancient Tomb, it's not though. But that's okay. Gonna make another construct. No, maybe. I'll play this for 2 first. Though for 2 stops me, bunch of stuff. Maybe for 3 I'll play. But then this Narrow Bridge is pretty good. I can't even play it for 1. I have to play for 1. I can't even play it for 0. I mean, I have to play for 1. I played for two, yes, I stopped some Eldrazi Mimic and stuff like that. But I also make so that if I draw a Strix, I can't play it. Alright, this Karn definitely doing its job. I mean, I have three Karns. It's not that it's unreasonable for me to draw. Alright, this Mishra's Factory was lethal to my Karn, but hopefully I can seize the match. We draw explosives that would have killed the Endless One. Alright, good game, good game. Karn definitely was insane in this match. Alright, what do I want? I want Spyglass and I guess Bedeem over the Forces. I mean, they have Cavern, but other than that, Forces can be strong. Do I even want Spyglass? I mean, Spyglass can name Wasteland, can name Iovulgin, can name... what else can they name? I mean, I don't really want to name Walking Ballista. Oh, I guess I have Chalice of the Void to cut. But yeah, definitely Spyglass and Padim, since there's nothing else. Let's go. Okay, so what happens here? I mean, this end is meh. This is not insane. We have only black cards, but we have Force of Will. Opponent's mulligan into 6. Also, they are on 51 cards. Pretty special. Maybe even 52? No, 51. And we have explosives that can stop something, maybe. Walking Ballista, Karn's very good. So I think that even if this hand is pretty weak, I think it's okay to keep. Alright, what do we do? Two Eldrazi Temple. Is this a Thonseer? If it's an Endless One, I'm gonna let it resolve and just cast these explosives. Okay, this is still fine. This Chalice is supposed to stop my explosives, but I can pay one with Corderless, and it'll come into play with zero counters. Very neat play. So, while the Chalice was a pretty cool move to stop my explosives, it wasn't because I drew my Inventor's Fair. Ooh, and Cavern of Souls now. This is gonna be hard to beat. I expect a Smasher right now. Zero. Sure. Go down to 16. The Schemer will get to kill it though. And the Karn will make a... yeah, the exact Karn. I go to 16 now. And next turn I have to pop up the explosives. Ooh, Mox Opal. This is a good draw. I mean, I can cast Tezzeret, but then it'll die. And I'd rather... oh no! Oh no! Oh no! Oh no! Should have cracked the explosives first. What happens if I do it now? Chalice is still on the stack. This was a huge punt. I would have played Ballista now. And then I would have had the fourth mana to cast... to cast Tezzeret with four artifacts in play. Things would have gone very well. I mean, opponent could just play Smasher now. And things would just be... and right now, I can never win. But in the other situation, I would have just had to deal with the Smasher. Okay, that's fine. Let's go game three. And I don't think I want to change anything. And let's go to game number three. On the play, and sure. Looking for like a Mox Diamond here so that we can turn two card. Let's start with Vault of the Whispers. Then on turn two, I don't think I can cast anything here. Oh yeah, I can't cast anything. Thorn of Amethyst, interesting. Alright, I'll play Mox Opal. And I'll play Ancient Tomb. So the next turn I can cast Karn. Let's see what happens. Alright, all is 4 mana. And another Thorn. Alright, so if I play Vault of the Whisper, I can cast Padim. I can also cast Padim without it, but I think I'd rather just cast Vault of the Whispers, just because it's an artifact. Alright. Let's cast Padim. Even though Padim is not insane. It's not insane, Padim, right? Okay, how much Thought Cast cost? 4. Padim is not insane because my opponent has 2 Thorn of Amethyst, so I'm not drawing in upkeep. Maybe it's just better for me to cast Thought Cast. Nah, I'll cast Padim. It's a blocker. If my opponent plays like Matter Reshaper or stuff like that, he'll just block. Also, it gives me a Vault of the Whispers protection from Wasteland. Let's see if this is a 5-5. Opponent plays a 5-5. Karn, can Karn be a 5? Can Karn make a 5-5? No, it will not. It will make a 4-4. Unless I draw a Vault of the Whisper or a Seath of Synod or Darkseid Citadel. Smashy. And Mother Reshaper. Alright, I go to 13. Draw Strix. Alright, let's cast Strix. Strix is very good. Also, now it will make me draw a card, even though I probably trade here. Alright, Seath of Synod. Now I can't cast Thought Cast for 2, which is good, it means that I don't tap the Ancient Tomb. And draw Force of Will, okay. Force of Will and blue card. And I can't cast it with Ancient Tomb untapped. Okay, this is a weird game. Weird and interesting game. Put them with more Ancient Tombs, so no Cavern, that's good. Ooh, they top. 2 Ancient Tombs. Walking Ballista for 2. I mean, it's not that great. I mean, Baleful Strix has X-proof. Though Padim can't block the Mother Reshaper. I don't think I have another window to cast this Force of Will, so I think I'll just do it now. I'm on 10 though, I lost 3 life now with this Force of Will. But the Walking Ballista would have been a threat. But then I should probably attack, because it forces me to trade and then I don't draw cards with Padim. So I go down to 6, but I kill their Reality Smasher. They have 2 cards. Still made land drop every turn, so they can have lands in hand. They also have Eldrazi's. Is this an endless one? Okay. I think I can deal with that. So my Karn cost 6. And I have 5, 10, 15. Yeah, I have to go down to 4 here. But it's okay, the Karn, the construct will be a 5-5. High five with Dexproof. Yeah, Pedim not successfully good, but because my opponent had to board in Thorn of Amethyst, which is also happened to be pretty strong, I would say. Okay, more creatures. Though I don't think they can attack if that's their main phase play. What's that? Chalice and Zero. Okay. So a lot of sideboard cards. Okay, I don't want to tap Ancient Tomb anymore. So I can play Walking Ballista for two. So I'm definitely gonna create the construct and play Walking Ballista for two. Then pass with my 7/7. I don't want to attack. Maybe I should have attacked though. Though, if I attack, then my opponent can just, you know, draw two cards with the Mother Shaper and the draw step, find the 5/5, and maybe just put me in a bad position. But maybe I should attack. I didn't realize my play was on 8, because the Ancient Tomb did something there. Alright, they drew something good. Reality Smash. Okay. That does pretty much nothing. There's zero cards in hand. They pass the turn. We go to our turn. Force of Will. Okay, Karn goes up to two. Probably will give us a land. Or a Demir Signet. Land it is. Force of Will cost 7. And I have it. So yeah, I'll just pass. Again, there's no point. If I attack with a construct, they can just double block. And I can pump Ballista and kill both. Or they can just block with Mother Shaper, flip creatures, and just attack me back. I think it's too risky to attack here. Maybe I could have played the Antiquities of War. Why didn't I play it? I wanted to leave mana on top for force, just in case they find like Endbringer. What do they find? Or Walking Ballista also would be. I would need a counter. Alright. Ooh. They attack. I mean, I'm definitely gonna block. I can block with Padim, actually. Yeah, one will block with Padim and the other one with the construct. Let's see what they reveal. Cavern of Souls. Alright, now this makes my play pretty bad, but maybe we can just win on the attack back. Yeah, they pay 2/4. Wow. What's this? Ratchet Bomb. Okay, so if we countered, so Ratchet Bomb is gonna kill the Ballista. I think now my opponent is dead on board. If we just force this. Second main phase, opponent 0 cards. Just cast Force. Okay. Then attack with all, and my opponent's dead. Right? Attack with all, opponent blocks the construct, and we're dead. Alright, this was a good match. This was definitely a good match. I hope you are enjoying this deck, since it's very weird. Karn is doing incredible stuff. And this is round number 2. We'll be back for more rounds left to go, but now it's time to remind you that Channel Fireball is the website. ChannelFireball.com is a website that lets you not only buy cards from them, but also trades with them. Go to ChannelFireball.com/buylist to check their buy price and be able to trade with them with a 30% store credit bonus. Alright. This and... I mean, we keep. Why we shouldn't. But it's not the turn 1 on Chalice, unfortunately. Unless we draw Mox Diamond. Still we're facing Delver of Secrets or Nimble Mongoose. Lots of Mongooses today. Okay, Darksteel Citadel, go. They attack me for 1, I'll take it. Then turn, post combat, another Nimble Mongoose, and a Scalding Tarn. Okay, that's strong. Alright, I want to play a Chalice. and I'm not afraid of anything. So I'm just gonna go Seed of Signet, Mox Opal, the Mer Signet, and then Chalice of the Void. I don't want to lose 2 life with the Ancient Tomb. This will get countered, and we'll go ahead with our lives. Yeah, we could have saved that by casting an Opal or a Tomb, I guess. Mm-hmm. Wasteland. Tuck. But my plan, but I had bigger plans. My plan was to resolve a Karn Sign of Orza here. So, Karn Sign of Orza. I can also play Tezzeret, Agent of Bolas, and make a Darksteel City level 5/5. I guess Karn is Karn token will be a 5/5 as well. This is tough. Cause they can both die to a bolt. I guess Tezzeret is kinda weaker to a bolt. No, I like to keep my lands able to be tapped. I mean it's not that land is not able to be tapped anymore if I minus 2 on the Darksteel Citadel. It's just that I'm not sure. So they didn't have bolt, which is very good. I was expecting the bolt on my card. I'm very not sure which was the best to play this turn. Play Brainstorm. Sequencing like this made me think that they have another fetch on the hand. Or they just, you know, hope like they have some bad cards to shuffle away. Let's see if they found a bolt for the card. Alright, I passed. Wow. Okay, so we get to put another construct into play, which should be very very, very strong. Okay, they can stifle this now. Then they can play Thoughtcast. Okay, they didn't. I play Thoughtcast. Then I'll play Tezzeret. Yeah, I guess I'll cast this Opal. I have 3, I don't really need to keep them, also this one is more good looking than the others, and opponent concedes, but yeah, with a cast Tezzeret, made the Darksteel Citadel unblockable, what's the name, 5/5, they just attack with a 6/6, and then, you know, the monkeys would have been just not very good. Alright, so on the draw, we can cut 2 forces for Pedims, and on the play, I like all the forces. Not sure about the Antiquities War. Maybe this matchup is just not very strong, and the Force of Will is just needed. It's just needed because, yeah, our deck is a strong deck, but if our opponent has we need to protect our threats. That's what it is. Let's go. All right, we have a one lander with Force of Will, the Mirror Signet Chalice. I'm gonna ship it. Alright, this is better. Not that much better. I mean, Tezzeret, Artifice Master, it's not insane. I'm not even sure why it's still in the deck. The reason, I think, is that once you lock up the game with Bridge, like we did in game 3, the first match, you need ways to win the game. And Tezzeret, with their topters, definitely does it. So you don't die to... Plus it's a blue card, so Force of Will. There you go. Wow, Basic Island, did not expect that. Ponder, not shuffle. Then what? Another cantrip? Teller of Secrets? Wasteland. Why did he play Island? Why did he play Seed of Cyanide? That was stupid. Okay, Null Rod. What? Don't you dare to cast Null Rod. Please don't have a Force of Will. No, I'm dead. Null Rod? Who plays Null Rod? Who plays Null Rod? Come on, that's not fair. Just dead. Okay. Back to reality. No Null Rod this game, please. Let's do a friendly path. Sorry, friendly pact. Yeah, let's go. Game number three. Alright, game number three against Null Rod deck. With a pre-land at the end. I'm gonna take it slow. With some Darksteel Citadels. Okay. So, can cast Darksteel Citadel. Mox Diamond. I'm not even sure if I need Mox Diamond. I just cast a Mox Opal Thoughtcast here. And if my opponent spell Pierce it or Flaster Storms it, that's fine. I could have played Mox Diamond and play around Spell Pierce. But I mean, my deck is pretty weak to Spell Pierce. And maybe we just don't play this Mox Diamond. Yeah, there it is. Spell Pierce. Immediately punished. Okay, Delver. And Delver. Alright, I think I can play 4. I think I'll play around Dates now. I think I'll play around Dates and rely a lot on this Walking Ballista. And they're forceful. And now we need to draw and snare and bridge. The Delver don't flips. With a 16. Walk with the Whispers. Yeah, had we cast that, that Mox Diamond turn 1 would have drawn 2 cards, and my opponent wouldn't have been able to cast his Spell Pierce anymore, probably. They would have just pitched it to the Force, most likely. Alright, we're on 10. We need to draw right now. Because if we don't draw right now, we are dead to Lightning Bolts and Monkeys now. And we're dead. Alright, lost twice to Canadian, but doesn't really look that bad of a matchup. But the games are cool, though. We'll be back for round number 4. Alright, can we get a turn 1 chalice? And we can. We can. The rest of the hand is unplayable. But Joe Clamb might just die to my Chalice of the Void on turn 1. If they have Force of Will, or if they play a deck that doesn't rely on chalice, that doesn't rely on 1 drops, I'm basically dead, because again, my hand doesn't do anything. My hope is that we turn off their hand as well. And eventually we draw lands and cast our spells, whereas our opponent will never be able to cast most of their spells. Many decks are very weak to Chalice on 1 in Legacy. All the blue decks, Reanimator, many combo decks. Gemstone Mine does not, because there's the Lion's Eye Diamond. And they pass, so that we get to dredge, but maybe they can't. I don't know. I was about to say they can't beat Ensnaring Bridge, but the thing is that I have 20,000 cards in my hand, and Also, sometimes I just play Flayer of the Hatebound with Dread Return. Just kill you that way. Alright, so now they'll probably just go Discard Hand for Landslide Diamond. Walking Ballista can kill. Can exile his name? No, what's his name? Bridge from Below. So there, that's something. But again, the rest of my hand it doesn't do anything, so I never need to draw like two lands to make it good. I guess Dimir Signet and land. Okay, come on, opponent. Opponent's deep in the tank if they want to crack the Landslide Diamond or not. They had a pretty strong start. If they had like a one drop, ooh, they don't do anything. Interesting. Oh, and in upkeep they go. Cabal Therapy, okay, so they just dredge 5. The dredge 5 with the Imp. Double Narcomoeba from Guilds of Ravnica. Ikorid. Sure. Okay, so they have an Imp in there, so they can't do anything and they pass. Our turn. We draw, come on, let's draw land. Come on, opponent, pass, please. Pass, pass, pass. Playing against some pretty slow opponents today. Certainly not not great experience. Alright, they decided that instead of passing, they would just sacrifice an Archimedes. But I'm fine with that. So they pass the turn, and we draw Force of Will. Doesn't do anything. And I don't want to trade, because I want to wait for Ensnaring Bridge from Below in their graveyards. I don't think they can ever put into play Corrid this turn, because they want to keep creatures in the graveyard to dredge the black creatures. To dredge, and they also then don't have bridge, so really no point in doing that. All right, now they found the Golgari Grave Troll and the Bridge from Below, and they pass with 2 imps in hand. All right, let's draw land. Mox Opal. Okay, this is. Hand of a land. So let's cast Thought Cast. Okay, I attack and pass. Alright, they probably now put the Golgari Thug into play. Sure. And the dredge 6. Okay. So 2 bridge from below. Oh, Stitcher Supplier. Uh-huh. So they don't have any more dredgers. Attack me for 4, I go down to 9. And then I can ping them. Yes, and exile the bridge. I don't want to ping any of the creatures because then they would make tokens. So they only 2 Ikorid and a Stitcher Supplier in the graveyard. We draw land. Yes, that turns on the Mox Opal as well. So that's very good. And we play Tezzeret the Schemer. Down to 7, but then I can block the Ikorid. They can't dredge because they finish their dredgers. They run out of dredgers. So go down to 7. I think now this is a. Oh no, this is the Schemer. I thought it was the other one. Alright, sure. Let's kill. Let's kill the Narcomoeba. Yeah, this was pretty bad. And this was pretty bad. I thought it was a 5-5, but yeah, it's okay. I'm still in a very good position here. My opponent is forced into. I mean, if they reanimate the Ikorid just to kill my Tezzeret the Schemer, I'm fine with that. They have to exile the Stitcher Supplier. They have only one card left, but no black cards. They have two Imp and a Thug in hand. Let's see what they draw. If they draw land, they can cast the Thug. I can go down to 4. If I go down to 4, then I would need to... I definitely would need to play the Strix. Play a Strix in order to block the Cory next turn. I think we can... We can find the light in this game. Opponent didn't sacrifice the Narcomoeba on that turn. The game would have been very much different. Okay, the Cory, the Tezzeret's dead. I'm fine with that. More lands. That's good. Okay, I think I'm gonna go down to 5 here. Cast this Keemer. Make a treasure. Crack the treasure. And play Strix. Okay, so they can have one Ikori, but I don't think they want. At this point, they have to draw. They have to draw very well, because there's Chalice on one. If they draw land and play Thug, it's something at least. Yeah. I think we've locked up this game. Thanks to the Chalice. Draw two. Tezzeret. I can cast the Antiquities of War. That will probably be. That will probably be pretty safe. But I have to. Yeah. Kinda don't want to lose life. For the Ancient Tombs. Alright, we'll get a land, I think. Or a Strix, maybe it's better. When it concedes. Alright! Hooray for the Chalice of the Void deck. Pelican's Dredge, so finally a Leyline is gonna come in. And not much else. Chalice is still good, Ballista Explosive is all good. I guess I'll cut some expensive cards. I don't really want to cut on all those blue cards because of Force of Will. Yeah, maybe I'll just leave in all the Antiquities of War just because they're blue. Yep, let's go with this. Ooh, and we opened with a ley line. All good news. And also infinite mana. And opponent is mining to 5. I think we are good to go. Okay, ley line here. Comes into play. Says okay. Opponent scries to the bottom. Plays a fight Coliseum. And plays a careful study. Let's open the graveyard as well so that it doesn't pop up the thing where the yellow thing here. So this is the exile pile, this is the graveyard pile. So now they would need both colored land and a destroyer for the ley line as well as developing their main plan. Okay. So I don't think I can cast this on turn 1. I mean, I can, right? That's funny, I can. 1 mana, 2 mana, 3 mana. Do we want to do it? Maybe we want to do it. This Antiquities War will find us lands. Yeah, let's do it. Turn 1, Antiquities of War. Could have been a Karn. Okay. Opponent can seize the match. Cool. All right. We'll be back for round number 5. All right, final match. Final match. A lot of mox opals, a lot of mulligans for my opponents. And we are on the draw, Skalintar. Let's see, what are we facing? Is it Kyla? Ponder. This could be show and tell. From the fact that they mulligan to 5, and that they play island and Skalintar. And bridge is usually very good against them. Put in shuffled. And we think play Darkstone City Let Go unless we draw. Not even sure what was the card that would have made us make a different play. Now we can cast a turn 2 Tezzeret or turn 2 Karn. Not sure what's the best. I'm definitely gonna keep Incinerate Bridge in my hand. I mean, I don't know if they play Show and Tell. In case they do, I'm gonna keep Incinerate Bridge in my hand just when they Show and Tell. That would be weak to sneak attack though. Let's see, fetch, ooh, swamp. All right, this is just a control deck that was pretty unlucky with the mulligans. And I am just going for, I think Tezzeret. Going up. We're getting Chalice. And yeah, now my opponent has to like Lightning Bolt the Tezzeret and attack. But that's okay if I had just made my... Ooh, is this a back to basics? Not bold. Sure. If I just make my Dark Skill Citadel a 5-5, you know. I don't think it's the end of the world. I could also play Karn in plus. That was also a possibility. Let's play Karn. Going up. See what we revealed. Tezzeret and the Antiquities of War. Yeah, looking for this Tezzeret. In order to kill that Strix. Alright, thoughts is I can now take out the Tezzeret. But the Karn can give me the Antiquities of War. Let's see. And I will cast it. Antiquities of War is, yeah, so I can cast Chalice and the Antiquities of War next turn. That was a pretty good Karn plus. Gain one life. So let's cast Chalice. Mm-hmm. That is not caster bolt. Ooh, yeah. Snapcaster Bolt, I think I'm gonna play Ensnaring Bridge. Can empty my whole hand. I can empty my whole hand, cast Bridge. And then, yeah, I guess go up, it's fine. Maybe go down. So the Strix will attack. No, I can't go down. If I go down, the Karn dies. Alright. I get Force, and I pass. So now the Strix can attack my Karn. Mm-hmm. This deck is pretty weak to Cold Against Command, but hopefully the opponent doesn't draw it. Alright. So if I cast Antiquities, how much mana do I have? 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So I can cast both the Antiquities of War and Breach. But then I will have two cards in my hand. Yeah, Force of Will does not really combo off that well with So I can take Strix and cast it. But then if I draw any colored card, I can't cast it. So I will have two cards in my hand and Karn would die. Maybe I just go up. Ooh, another Force. Playing gives us Darksteel Citadel though. If opponent gave me Force, I couldn't stop them to attack with Snapcast Image. I would need to force my own bridge. Just not a play I'm thrilled about. Now I even have 5 mana up to counter something with Force. Okay, Karn goes down to 2 again. Draw land, so now I can minus and get the Antiquities of War. But then again, Strix would attack, so yeah, I can't do it. But if I find a land, I would have two cards in hand. Both are lands. One force and one land. Okay, so I can use the Inventor Sphere, but what artifact can I get? Can I get Walking Ballista? I don't think that's very bad. Get Walking Ballista, play for 2. Maybe I can't even mine this Karn so that I can force their Force. Yeah, I think I'll do it. I'll mine this Karn and get like a Baleful Strix. Alright, this is into play, and I pass. Now I'm weak to him to Turek, but it's not the end of the word. I didn't want to get back the Antiquities War because in case I needed to play Force of Will, because if my opponent has a Force of Will in hand, I would have needed to pitch that, whereas now I can just plus Karn and then get the Antiquities of War the turn after. Which is like a very strong payoff now. Opponent, come on. Okay. Snapcaster Mage. That's fine. We can block one. That's why I didn't want to ping immediately the Snapcasters. Because now I can block and ping the other two. Whereas if I just pinged, the Karn would have died. I could have forced it, but I don't think it's a threat. So Karn stick around for one more turn. And then we have Strix to block it. To block the Snapcaster, I mean. Opal will go into the hand. Blue and black. Let's play Strix. Yeah, Karn plus Bridge is definitely a combo, but Karn is helping us going through the deck. And we'll pass. There's no point in playing Opal. I might just play next turn and use the mana once again. Opponent concedes. Hooray. The Karn did it. So yeah, next turn we could have just go back. Now even don't worry anymore about the bridges. And just go off with Force of Will backup. Playing against control decks. And I definitely want Blue Elemental Blast for Curl Against Command. I like also Painful Truth, I think. Maybe I cut explosives and walking ballista. Maybe I cut two walking ballistas and have some pedims. Some pedims in the mix. Cut maybe both, like two bridges. Again, I'll leave just one because I have the one inventor server. That's a lot of one-offs, but I think it's okay. Maybe I'll cut most diamond. Actually, I don't have anything to board in. Maybe I'll have ley lines. How do you think about ley line? Just make my deck slightly different. I think ley line might be very strong, even like in the late game, even later in the game. Yeah, and I'm not sure about Flusterstorm. Maybe Flusterstorm is just better than Force Fulfill in general. Now, let's try. We sideboard in 11. Let's see if it works out. It definitely works out, since we drew Leyline in our opener. Our opponent's playing Grixis, so they don't have access to the graveyard anymore. So there's no way they can beat, they can kill a Leyline of Grixis. They can splash for green for Assassin's Trophy, but didn't seem like the case. Alright, see if they have an M2 Turek. Since they fetched for basic, it's clear to me that they don't play into Turek at all. Alright, that's a good draw. Let's play Strix. Another good draw. I like all those four drop, because opponent is kind of forced into dealing them. Alright. So maybe they boarded out. They maybe boarded out back to basics. So the fetch for island was something weird. Okay, so now I want to play one of these two four drops. Put them to stopped out so they can't interact with the counter. They can have a red elemental blast, but we're gonna create the token. We're gonna create a okay, that force of will. Sure. Sure. What's that, Jace? That's annoying. I wish one of these two blue metal blasts would have been a force of will. Maybe I should just not board out force of will every time, as I'm doing. Alright, let's draw another four drop. This is a four drop. Not the strongest, though. This inventor's fair can go get walking ballista. Not much more. The blue metal blast is here just for cool against command, so maybe it should be just a one of and not a two of. And they're both gone now. And we know the way is gonna clear up the Strix. Sure. We need Karn now. Or Dimir Signet. Yeah, it's okay. Let's concede the game. Okay, so we want Spyglass. I think I'll cut the Strix. Sorry, the Blue Metal Blast. I keep just the Flask of Storms. I don't think I can play Force. Just not many blue cards. Maybe I don't. Didn't even. Yeah, maybe I just cut Bridges. And I mean, they do play Flask of Storm. They do play into Turek. We just something like this. Some mid range, some mid in between. Maybe all the walking ballistas are good. Nah. Yeah. Yeah, maybe yes. Okay. I think this is fine. I'm still liking my line. Maybe now that my opponent saw it, it's gonna board out like Gurma Gangler and such. Yeah. Okay. Alright, let's go. Game number 3. Alright, final round for this league, for this deck. Start with a mulligan. This will be a keep. Don't think I want to play turn 1 walking ballista, that seems pretty weak to me. Hopefully this is a thought seize. I kinda need this Antiquities of War. Okay. I mean, I have a lot of payoffs to draw. I have mana. I have a Chalice of the Void to draw right now, here. Chalice, no, Thought Cast. Maybe I needed to play this Walking Ballista just because then the Thought Cast would have cost less. The thing is that it's very weak. Like, I want to use my Walking Ballista maybe later in the game. And maybe that's why it's not a 3-of. Maybe it should have just been a 2-ofs. Okay, is my opponent Brainstorm locked? They're not. Mox Opal. So now this Thought Cast costs 3. Do they have a counter? Revenant Blast? Sure thing. Mm-hmm. Yeah, pretty bad situation now. I need my four drops now. I need my four drops. And the zero cards in hand, sure. And come on, Karn. Alright. Cast the Chalice. See if they have a Brainstorming Response or a Force. Alright. I mean, they still haven't played the Coldness Command. But I'm sure that they do play it. Alright, Explosive is gonna have another 2 for 1. It's all the 2-for-1s in the world, but we are drawing. No. Not that. Yeah, I'll tap this. If I draw Strix, I can't cast it. I can draw Land Strix and can still cast it. Ooh, Force Speech Force. Alright. And skinning my 2 stuff. We are 3 versus 0. Strix, okay. Come on, let's draw Planeswalker. Planeswalker. Ancient Tomb. Gonna play it because of a Coldness Command. Or Liliana of the Veil. Mm-hmm, so I'm gonna can art cast 4, but I think that they already used 2. Back to basics. It's rough. Alright, drew Padim. Which is fine, but the problem is that if I cast Padim, I can't cast anything else. So I'm not doing it. Not a Padim. There's no way for me to kill that back to basics. I boarded out. explosives. But I mean, this deck plays 4 opals, 4 Dimir Signet, or maybe 3 Dimir Signet. Yeah, 3 Dimir Signet. It's not like the end of the word, the back to basics. Alright, I'm gonna concede. Okay, okay, 2-3. Not the worst, but it's okay. It's okay. This deck was fun. We had some fun games. I think that the Tezzerator, the Antiquities of War, was definitely when we won on turn one with Antiquities War was kind of great. I think this deck was fun. Thanks for watching, and we'll be back for more Legacy videos, more times on Channel Fireball. So subscribe to the Channel Fireball on YouTube so that you can see immediately when they're up. And press like to this video if you did. So thank you and goodbye.